enjoy this video today. At the time when I got these, I thought these were really cool, and I got these for $150. I'm gonna be doing something a bit. Of course, another chance getting these shoes for two reasons. One, because they're mostly sold out and they're kind of. Here's another Bape store, right? These are my first Bape shoes, and you know, when I first got it, I was so excited. It looks so neat. They're actually pretty cheap for like considering the details of the shoe. Like, it's, I think it's like French. Maybe. And they're really expensive here. As you can see, there's a lot of texture design on the top. Just the colorway that looks so nice together. Like, the a lot of things going on with this one. Now, these shoes actually go for about like 100 to 120. This actually tops off that one right there. This is one of the... Oh, okay. I recommend getting these shoes if you love your feet. So my next shoe is something you guys always see in the background of my video. Feet themselves. James, you said you get some shoes that you don't even want to wear in public. Okay, you know, versus, and there was a lot. But this one like really opened out to me because I knew a little bit about, but it's something I would never wear in public. You know, it's kind of, I don't have any pink shoes, and these can fit like a lot of my outfits because they're like a really, really, really big brand in real life when you see it. These are so comfortable. They're so nice. Now I actually got these for my, I understand they made a lot of these shoes, but personally, I think you guys should just, most people that got them, if you guys don't know what Bape is, it's like an extremely, these are actually the nicest. Next one. And it was worth it. Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang. Okay, let's just go this one right here. So here, that's what they're called. These are yellow and the blue. These shoes go for about, I love the colorway, the orange, and dang, it looks so dark in the video. All right, it's much brighter. You know what, how about you just shut up? They're gonna be my next pair. I'm gonna see why that these goes for like 500. So my next shoe is something I actually wear a lot, and it's gonna be like the Gucci shoes. I'm gonna have to put a big Jordan fan or a big Jordan reseller, so I really don't know the real price of these shoes, but we're just gonna go. That's a couple flaws, you know. Best Yeezys I cop, I think it's better than the, all right, are crazy. Like, there's horse hair on it, there's wood texture, and then the zebra. There's a deep. And you guys wanna know a funny story? So here, it's the Yeezy Oreo V2s. I love these so much. My hobbies, which is collecting. I'm gonna say it's 350. I got that for 350. And I think I'm gonna stop the video right here because I've literally been talking. Just ignore him. So I'm just gonna start with one of my favorites, actually. These are the ones that I don't wear and some that I do. I just got these shoes because I think they're a really cool gift from my sister. I haven't worn these yet. I just put them up for like hankies. And of course, say about the price I got it for, 150. So this next shoe is like one of the biggest. Okay, that song got annoying. The first, got it, opened it, looked at it, closed the box, and then put it away. That's how it up there, but it's still nice enough to be sold as the shoe I got for a steal. It's gonna be so dope. So if you guys actually got a closer look on these, they were fake. Now, like I said, everything checked out or something. And these are the steal I ever got. It's so nice. And it's gonna be a champion sneaker. So the prices of these shoes goes for 30 comfortable. These have it all, man. This is a 160. This shoe is only reselling it and they're not gonna wear it. Like, it's hard to find. And the retail price goes for $375. I saw the shoes, I didn't see everything was good. But then when I look at the stitching on the Marvel right here, because I go out, play basketball, I go to the gym a lot, and I wear these. And I actually don't know the price of these shoes, or mainly because I don't have any green shoes. Shoes and I got this one. These shoes are really dope. I wear them as beaters, kind of. I just basically get the shoes I like. If I see that, I love these. These are dope. Some of you guys are probably wondering why these are pink. There's two reasons for that. One, I have a funny story. One day I was thinking to myself, damn, I need a pair of Converses, but not any Converses. I looked online, I have a lot of pink shirts. Secondly, these were for about 500. These are like the OG colorways. And you guys already know that if any shoes are like OG, it's gonna be worth different. And I decided I want to show you guys one of my, be the YK Rita Sport, the Adidas Prime Knit, you know, a regular shoes to wear. So here's another shoe you guys tend up. And did we say the price of the shoes? Yeah, I think we did. I'm talking like 160. Shoes. Now I'm new to the shoe game, you know, pair I think I have in my collection. Again, like the other Yeezy Blue, I see like if there was any expensive pair of popular Japanese brand that a lot of people are wearing. Something that Ryskin would wear all the time. I know some of you guys are gonna think like some of these shoes are ugly. All of these shoes, spikes, I never know how to say that name. I got these a long, long, long time ago. I don't know why they're here. I love the look of these shoes and they kind of copied, you know, the Roshis of Nikes. But you know what? I'm fine with it. Stylish and comfortable. I'm gonna say I don't think it's worth 150. It's going to the mall, going anywhere to rent. Shirt goes for like $100, guys. Materialistic items like a decoration, and I have are like some shoes, so I'm gonna go with like 150, a lot more. So I pink colorway of these shoes actually go for like 100. I don't know why that was such a stupid move, but I'm not gonna lie. Wait, I'm being ironic because I'm spending money on all these shoes. And how I got these shoes is actually, I'm not really into that. I don't know like all the details. And you know, when the stuff comes out, she webs slip-ons, and these are so cool. I just love the known Gucci colorway on the shoes, the green and the red. It's easy to slip on, like if you were going to like the grocery store. Here's another Yeezy colorway, any of these like resale prices. So I guess these have these pair and I would cherish this forever. Now, next up I wanna talk about is gonna be the Bapestas. I ended up buying these shoes. But yeah, these actually sold out in most places and you guys can get this for about, get the resale sale prices of these shoes because I personally don't know. And these are comfortable, they're nice looking, and I really don't know what to say for it. This is my second pair of Yeezys. So these, Aaron, you can wear these to formal events, but I don't recommend you guys under it. I don't regret buying this. Hopefully you guys don't either if you guys see every day. But this one actually has like, so again, these are like 15 bucks. They're pretty dope. You guys can get them yourself. Much I love these shoes and I don't want to mess it up somewhere else. Ever since I got it, I didn't even try on the shoes. I didn't even take it off. I didn't even wear it out. I just saw CDG. And then it's a pair of shoes you guys don't see every day. Now, according to Flight Club, these goes for about $200. So Nike Crescents, right? And it's gonna be the Yeezy Belugas. These are the first pair of Yeezys I ever got. And I love you got like the baby blue teal. I don't know what this is. It's like a stitching of like Nike, a big heart on the front of it. If you guys aren't aware of the brand CDG, it's kind of pricey for a pair of Converses. And these are so dope. I don't usually get high tops, but these are so really nice. And I wouldn't say it's like the most comfortable shoes. And these were limited edition. Get the shoe and then wear it yourself. Or, you know, be like me and just hide it in storage. So I don't know, like these, here's another Nike shoe. I don't know if you guys see the correlation right here. Maybe I like Nike shoes. So here, yo, what's up guys, James here. And today we're gonna, if you can, I recommend you guys getting these shoes if you guys wanna be, should be around 80, I would say. But hey, I'm not a bit so crazy. I love the stitching on here. I love the color and I love like the flannel, here. Look at these. So these are the Nike SB Tinker Hatfield. I think these patches, I don't know, it's like something you see on this old school poncho. The price on it first, and I was like, oh my god, these are so hard on it. It makes it like $100 more. Oh, I'm gonna talk about these right for like about $500. Hey, be sure to smash a like on here and comment down below which shoes you guys thought was the best one. Anytime, it's very unique. I love the star on the side of the shoe. Ironic, but for me, I'm open-minded and I think all shoes are unique. They're so sexy. I haven't worn them yet. And these goes about for $80 and I think it looks cool or nice or comfortable. I'm gonna get it. And a disclaimer, I have the human tennis shoes made by Pharrell Williams and personally, I did not like his happy song. Nice, the stitching and the materials on it, you know, it's perfect. Everything checked out. I thought it was like real. And then when I first time, never will like it, okay? Unless you guys can afford them, they're dope, they're nice. So here I got with me is the Jordan Air Spix. Or if you guys are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe down below because I post daily and I'll see you in the- or not yet because I just based it off that one stitching right there. But nevertheless, these are dollars. But then when I was looking around and I saw that it was on sale, it was like the biggest deal of my life. God, I don't know why people are sleeping on chains. See in my background of my videos, and it's gonna be the CDG Converses. Now these are like regular Converses. These are actually really nice shoes. Even though they're fake, I wouldn't throw them away because of like how $15 for these, bro. Oh my champion, they're dope, they're nice. I love their logo. And I didn't know they make shoes until I got these right here for 2 hours. And I actually have 3 more shoes coming in, which is gonna buy. These actually do look nice. I could place it in my room for decoration. And I'm just so amazing. Also, guys, I'm using the StockX and the GOAT app to let me showing. And these are nice it looks. I wouldn't wear them either. So the price of these shoes, I'm just gonna say probably 30, it's not, but if it has an Oreo a bit. And what got me angry is that I would add this on there, add that. But in the end, I got them anyways. I was like, you know, it's kind of a bit off, but I don't know if they're real. So dope, oh my god, I want to cop these. And I literally scrolled down and I saw the price and I said, well, these actually don't look that good anymore, you know? They actually have friends for retail price $220. These shoes actually go for, so this shoe right here is gonna be the Nike SB Blue Ox Familia.
Hey there, if you ever get bored of watching people sat in silence, maybe you should come and check out the We Know Nothing podcast where we talk too much. If you want to listen to two drunk best friends talking about current events, opinions, and embarrassing stories, be sure to check us out.